TJ Del Santo. We had a pretty active morning on the radar. Looks like we've got kind of a break in the action, TJ.
Yeah, for now. And then we have some more showers that'll be coming in as we go through the afternoon hours, but probably not as widespread or heavy as what we had earlier. Let's get a look at that live radar. And you can see we've got another batch of green on the lower portion of your screen. Well, we picked up about a quarter inch to a third of an inch of rain south and east of Providence earlier in the morning. We actually had some thunder with this little cell right in here, but I think that's going to be passing over perhaps Buzzards Bay and Cape Cod, probably missing Rhode Island and nearby Massachusetts, but we have the chance for some more scattered showers as we go through the afternoon hours. Threat tracker for today, not much of an impact from those showers. Wednesday and Thursday look to be relatively quiet here in southern New England. Here's a live look at the city of Providence from East Providence. You see we've got lots of clouds out there, and we've had some glimmers of sun from time to time. Here's Newport, and again, you can kind of make out the top of the bridge there. But yeah, we are still looking at a lot of low clouds and fog. Temperature up to 62 degrees now in the city by the sea, with a wind from the south 13 miles an hour at the moment. Now, satellite radar picture is showing this little batch of showers in here across southern New England, associated with what's going on, a little disturbance in the upper levels of the atmosphere, and is actually a weak front off to our south. We also have a stationary front off to our north and west, helping to produce those showers. Those showers across New York, northern New England will bypass us, but I think we're still looking at the chance for a couple of showers from time to time as we go through the afternoon and even through the nighttime tonight and into Wednesday morning. With the hour by hour forecast, we are looking at some spotty showers. Notice not terribly widespread at all. Here we are at 3 o'clock Wednesday afternoon. Still lots of clouds, but I think we get some sun for the afternoon tomorrow, and mainly dry for Wednesday afternoon and into Wednesday evening. So forecast for the rest of today, temperatures will be in the upper 60s with a few showers possible, not as widespread as what we had earlier in the day. I had to put a number on it, probably about a 30% chance of rain. Now for tonight, we are looking at, again, those spotty showers around with some more areas of fog developing, and overnight lows relatively mild. We're looking at a low temperature down around 60 degrees. Keep in mind, over the weekend, we had that morning low of 35. So 60 degrees for an overnight low, not too tough to take. Here's that 7-day forecast. Again, maybe some isolated rain showers Wednesday morning. On Thursday, we're looking at a blend of sunshine and clouds. Look at the temperature, up around 74 degrees. Little treat here in mid to late October. On Friday, sunshine continued relatively mild and dry, about 66 degrees. Let's take a look at that weekend. On Saturday, we're looking at lots of sun with highs in the upper 60s. I think we begin to see some changes as we go through Sunday. We do have the chance for some rain showers, and notice it does get a little cooler with highs in the upper 50s. Monday might have some showers around as well, about 62. You can get your weather anytime at WPRI.com or the WPRI app.
All right, as always, app's a great place to go. Thank you, TJ. Want to check some other news now? Well,